Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you some power tips on how to use the Max application switcher. So if you've never used the application switcher before, the keys that you're going to need to use in order to do this will be the command key shown down here, as well as the tab key, which is shown here, as well as this key right above it. Okay, so let's get started and take a look at what happens when we depress the command and the tab key. So these are all the applications that I'm running. If I hit the tab key again, 1, 2, 3, 4, as you can see, it switches between applications. Once I let go of the command key, that application will open up. And in this case, I hit the finder key, so we're not really seeing a difference. But let's hit the command tab key again, and this time, let's tab through it. As you can see, I'm hitting the tab once while still holding down the command key. And then I've selected Photoshop. I'm now going to release the command key and Photoshop will come up. So that's how you can switch between applications rather quickly. Some other features that exist in the application switcher are this. If you hold the command and tab key, as you can see, you're going in one direction. If you want to go in the other direction, you then use this key right above it. And if you click on that, you go in the other direction. So you can go back and forth. If you have a long list of applications, this is how you can do it. Once you find the application you want, you release the command key, and that application comes up. So this can help if you have a lot of stuff on your desktop. If you hit the command tab key, and you want to hide an application, so let's go to iTunes. Let's say I wanted to hide the iTunes application. So now you can see I'm highlighting iTunes. I'm now going to click the H key while I still have the command key pressed. So here we go, I'm going to press the H key and that's going to hide iTunes. If I again do that for Photoshop, I'm going to hit the H key while Photoshop is highlighted, still holding the command key. Now I hit H, it will hide it. If I hit H again, it brings it back up. So that's another way of using the application switcher. Let's say I want to quit out of Safari. So I will click over here to Safari, but this time I'm going to use the Q key for quit, which is this one here. So I'm still holding the command. I'm now going to hit Q, and that is going to quit Safari. So that is helpful if you want to quit a bunch of applications. So I'm holding down the command key, and I'm actually hitting the Q key, and that is quitting all these applications rather quickly. As you can see, I can quit through quite a few of them very quickly. One last thing that you can do besides quitting and hiding is actually if you have a particular application hidden, meaning it's, in your dock, but it's not really showing on your screen, what you can do is this. If let's say it's Google, and I'm going to hide it right now, okay? And now I'm going to select the Google, but this time when I release the command key, I'm going to hold down the Option key and then release the Command key. So the Option key is over here. And I'm going to release the Command key. And you can see it immediately opened the hidden application. So let's do that one more time. I'm holding the Command tab for the application switcher. I'm going to go to iTunes and I'm going to hide it using the H key while still holding the Command key. But now when I select iTunes, I'm going to now hold the Command key, switch over to the Option key, and nothing happens, right? Because you have to hold the Command key and the Option key at the same time and then release the Command key for iTunes to pop up. So this really works out very, very nicely. It's a quick way of getting around your applications, especially when you have a lot of them. And very quickly, if I wanted to switch to Photoshop, Command Tab, use the Tab key until Photoshop is selected, release the command, and now I'm in Photoshop. If I wanted to Command Tab and hide iTunes, then I would hit the H key, and as you can see, it's hidden. If I go Command Tab, and I also wanted to hide the Google Chrome, I would also click the H key, and you can see that that opened H for opening it and hiding it. So it's not actually quitting the application, that's just putting it in the dock. And one last thing, if I want to quit Google Chrome, Command, which I'm still holding down, but this time instead of the H for hide, I'm going to use the Q to quit. And there you go. So That's how you use the application switcher. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you like it, give me a like. If you like some of these tips, please subscribe to my channel. And thanks for listening.